Thank you, Senator Kane. Some final questions. I understand President Bolsonaro gutted Brazil's environment and indigenous ministries and replaced important officials with military personnel with no conservation experience. Are we doing anything to support President Lula's efforts to adequately staff the ministries tasked with combating deforestation? Either one of you who has an answer.
So Brazil has a wealth of expertise in these areas, and President Lula has traveled here to meet with the president, with his Minister of Environment, Marina Silva, and Special Envoy Kerry met with her during his trip to the region. And we believe that they bring a very strong, strong team to the table to address these issues, and we stand ready to work with them and support them in their efforts.
Okay. Are we committed to engaging subnational actors who are working to preserve Brazil's vitally important forest resources? Mr. Duke?
Yep. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Yes, and I'll add, in regards to your last question around indigenous communities in Brazil, that when Special Presidential Envoy for Climate Kerry was in Brasilia, he did meet also with Minister Guajajara, who's in the new Minister for Indigenous Communities in Brazil. And we have, over the last 2 years in our office, met multiple times with stakeholders focused on human rights and economic welfare of the indigenous communities in Brazil. So we'll continue to engage on that. In regards to staffing, we recognize that Brazil has the capacity that Assistant Secretary Nichols just referred to, and we are seeking through this partnership with other governments, philanthropy, the private sector, to help Brazil with resourcing its overall efforts to end deforestation and illegal activities in the Amazon, including through the Amazon Fund and other results-based approaches, and that should help with staffing as well.
So I take from your answer that we are prioritizing the inclusion of indigenous communities to ensure their voices are also front and center in our Amazon deforestation prevention efforts.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Chairman. Absolutely. And we see in the Amazon Fund itself structured engagement of indigenous communities as part of how that mechanism works. And we expect that any work we do in partnership with Brazil and supportive of Brazil's objectives to end deforestation and illegal activities in the Amazon region will centrally involve indigenous communities.
In addition to having vast rainforest and terrestrial biodiversity, Brazil has a sprawling coastline, almost twice the length of the United States. As a champion of Save Our Seas, the 2.0 Act, and a follow-on that we are in the midst of working, we cannot forget about our oceans. How are we engaged with Brazil on efforts, for example, to combat plastic pollution? And also, is Brazil concerned about China's overfishing in their territorial waters?
So we have a robust dialogue with Brazil on maritime and ocean issues, particularly our cooperation in the South Atlantic. Illegal, unregulated, unlicensed fishing is a threat to all of the countries with oceans in our hemisphere. And obviously the presence of large Chinese commercial fishing fleets just off the territorial waters of the countries in South America is a major problem, and they turn off their transponders, and then who knows where they go.
Do the Brazilians, they'll see that as a problem?
I don't know what Brazil's specific position is on that topic, but I can look into that and get back to you.
I would appreciate that, because I know that they're dealing with China economically, but here, China's overfishing these territorial waters in a way that is tremendous consequence economically, tremendous consequence in terms of biodiversity in the region. Lastly, and then I'll turn to Senator Van Hollen. Brazil is the second Latin American country to be designated as a major non-NATO ally. And since 2018, the United States has committed nearly $6 million to help reinforce security, defense cooperation, and the rule of law. In particular, we've invested in efforts to bolster law enforcement cooperation, strengthened information sharing, counterterrorism, cyber crime, financial crimes, trafficking of narcotics and weapons. So going back to the ranking member's questions on the docking of Iranian ships, what can we do to enhance security cooperation between Brazil and the United States under President Lula?
Well, we look forward to the U.S.-Brazil defense dialogue later this year as an opportunity to discuss our defense cooperation and defense relations with Brazil. Brazil is a global leader in peacekeeping historically, and that role is important and one that we support. The opportunities for commercial sales of U.S. weapon systems to Brazil is something that I think we should explore more deeply, and to continue exchanges between our law enforcement and our militaries.
More likely or less likely to have Brazil's help in countering China's authoritarianism and its aim in the Western Hemisphere?
I think that we need to have a dialogue based on values with Brazil and talk about what are the values we'd like to see in our hemisphere. And I know that President Lula strongly supports democracy and human rights, and we hope that we can work to promote those values throughout our region.
Okay. Doesn't answer my question. More likely or less likely to stand up to dictators and autocrats in the Western Hemisphere?
Brazil has condemned the actions of Nicaragua, for example, in the stripping of the citizenship of those who oppose the brutal Ortega Murillo regime. And I hope that Brazil will continue to speak out against human rights abuses in our region.
Senator Van Hollen.